This is the SNES Mini, a classic Nintendo mini console with 20 games. But what if you want more than 20 games? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to hack the SNES Mini. Stick around, because it's Tech Quiz time. Hey guys, hope you've got your hacking shoes on. My name's Jonathan, and this is Tech Quiz time, where I create technology tutorial and review videos. In this video, I'm going to show you how to hack the SNES Mini in a few simple steps. Firstly, though, I would like to thank Elizabeth and Jessica for letting me lend this console. They're my two biggest fans. If you haven't got your own SNES Mini console yet, I'll also leave some links down in the description for where you can purchase your own. All right, let's pop over to the computer. So one of the first things you'll need to do is you'll need to download the software to allow you to do this. And that's from the link in the description or on the screen right now. Once you're there, you need to go to the releases section, and here you'll see the latest release. Now I've tried playing around with the web installer, which does require administrator access. So in order to keep this tutorial as simple as possible, I'm going to get you to download the normal portable edition in the zip file. So click on that link, and once it's downloaded, we're going to extract the folder. I'm using 7-zip in this tutorial, which you can download from the link in the description below. Once that's extracted, we'll go inside the folder and we'll launch the executable file. The first message that will come up will be a message telling you to select your console type. Now, hakchi2 actually caters for both the Mini NES and the Super NES Mini. So choose your region by clicking on the button and then hit OK. So before we get too excited, what we're going to do is we're going to dump the kernel of your original Super NES Mini. So to do that, what we need to do is we need to go to the kernel menu and select dump kernel. Now this will bring up this little screen here with a few instructions of what you'll need to follow. So the first thing you'll need to do is make sure your SNES Mini is turned off. Next, you'll need to connect your SNES Mini to your PC via a USB cable. Now, with the SNES Mini still turned off, what you need to do is you need to hold down the reset button and switch the SNES Mini on. You'll need to keep the reset button held down, and you'll notice that the power light doesn't come on. This means that it's now ready to be able to dump the kernel. So to make sure that we've got the correct driver installed, click Install Driver, and this will go ahead and do that process. A black command screen prompt will come up, and what you'll need to do here is it will tell you that the driver has been successfully installed, so just press Enter. And after a short wait, what will happen is your kernel will be dumped to a folder called, ironically, dump. Make sure you keep this file somewhere really safe, because this is your original kernel, and if you ever want to go back to a stock SNES Mini, then this is the file that you will need. So now that little bit of housekeeping is out of the way, what we can do now is add some games. Now this is where a little disclaimer comes in. In some regions of the world, using ROMs is actually illegal, but the general consensus is that if you own the physical cartridge and your local laws allows it, then you can actually have a digital backup of that cartridge. So please only use games or cartridges that you actually own. So with that said, what we'll do is we'll add some games to our new SNES Mini. So down the bottom, click the big button that says add more games. And here, what we can do is we can select as many or as little games as we want. And once we're done, we just click the open button. This will start the loading process of loading the games into hakchi2. So once that's done, you'll now notice your games are in the list. And to make them look a little bit more pretty, what we can do is we can click on a game and then click the Google button. What this will do, it will Google for images that are related to that game. So once you're happy with one of the images that are there, all you need to do is double click on it and it will apply it to that game. Go through and do this for your other games, and once you're done, we can click the Synchronize button down the bottom. Now, if this is the first time you're flashing your SNES Mini, it will come up with this message, basically saying that you will need to flash the custom kernel to your SNES Mini. So we just need to click yes here. This will begin the process of uploading the custom kernel to your SNES Mini. Now, it will take a little while, but once it's done, it should come up with a congratulations message. And now is the time that it will actually copy across your games. So click the OK button and this will start the copy process. And depending on how many ROMs you've put on the list, will depend how fast this happens. In my case, it was almost instantaneous. Now we can just click done and literally we're done. Turn off your SNES Mini and unhook the USB, plug it into your TV and boot it up, and away you go. Now what you'll notice here straight away is that there's a new folder icon. Now this is where your new ROMs are actually stored. So select a folder. And here we can see all the games that we put in there, and we can launch one and away we go. How awesome is that? So that was a relatively easy process. Now for some people, they are gonna come across some errors. It's just a fact of life, unfortunately. Sometimes things go wrong. So if you do have a problem, leave a comment down below and let some others know, so to see if what they can help out, or maybe I can direct you in the right place to have a look and see if you can fix it yourself. Again, a huge thanks to Jessica and Elizabeth for letting me lend this console so I could do this. And just like those two girls, they're subscribed. If you haven't already, then make sure you do. And if you are a subscriber, then make sure you hit that bell icon so you can get notified whenever I release a new video. If you can like and share this video with your friends, then that would be fantastic and it really helps the channel a lot. And as I always say, imagine, learn, create.